Good morning, my dear students. Yesterday I had taught you how to make sentences in future tense. Today we will be dealing with the usages of present tense, past tense and the future tense. In today's class we will be dealing with two sections of present tense. They are simple present and present continuous tense. So we begin with the simple present. When and where to use the simple present tense? Let's go to the first usage of it. We use the simple present tense in expressions in the immediate present. Immediate present means at the present. Let's take an example here. She wants to speak at once. In this particular example, the word at once indicates or shows the immediate present, and so we have to use the simple present tense. So once again, we use the simple present tense in expressions in the immediate present. Immediate present means which is going to happen at present. We move to the second usage, that is when a sentence begins with there or here. Here we have got two examples. Here comes a train, there goes the bus. Let's go through these examples very clearly. As the sentences begin with here and there, we use the simple present tense. Let's take the first example, here comes a train. This particular sentence begins with here. So we have to use the simple present tense. Take the second example, there goes the bus. This particular example begins, or this particular sentence begins with there, so we are using the simple present tense. We move on to the third usage of it. We use a simple present tense when something is generally true, to indicate something that is generally true. Let's take two examples here. People need food. It snows in winter here. Take the first example, people need food. It is something which is generally true. What is true? People need food. Take the second example, it snows in winter here. What is the truth in that particular statement? The truth in the statement is that it snows in winter here. So what does it mean? These two examples indicate things that are generally true. So we use the simple present tense. Let's take the next example. Let's go to the next usage of simple present tense. We use a simple present tense to express a permanent situation. Permanent situation means something which is not going to be changed. Take the example, our office faces east. This example shows something that is permanent. What is the permanent situation given in the example? That is, our office faces east, which is a permanent situation. So we use a simple present tense. We move on to the next one. The next usage of simple present is that we use a simple present tense to express a habitual or regular action. It means that you do this particular action regularly. Let's take the examples. I play football every day. Second example, I get up early daily. The first example, playing football is a habitual action which is denoted by the word called every day. The second example, I get up early. Getting up early is a regular action which is denoted by the word daily. These two examples indicate the actions that are done regularly or daily. So we use the symbol present tense. The first example, playing football every day. The second example, getting up early daily. Next usage of simple present tense is that we use a simple present tense to express a future action. I have given two examples here. School begins at 9 a.m. tomorrow. The factory reopens next Monday. These two examples imply or indicate actions that are going to happen in future. The first example, the school is going to begin at 9 a.m. tomorrow, which is a future action. The factory reopens next Monday, which means the reopening is a future action which will happen on next Monday. So to indicate or to express a future action, we can also use a simple present tense. Next usage of simple present tense is that we use it to introduce quotations. Let's take the examples. Shakespeare says, life is a drama. William Wordsworth says, the nature is beautiful. As these two sentences are the quotations given by different people. Take the first example, life is a drama is a quotation given by William Shakespeare. So to introduce that particular quotation, we are using the simple present tense. So it goes like this, Shakespeare says, life is a drama. The second example, the nature is beautiful is a quotation given by William Wordsworth. So we are supposed to use a simple present tense. So it goes like this, William Wordsworth says, the nature is beautiful. What is the next usage of simple present tense? We use a simple present tense in time clauses introduced by conjunctions of time such as when, until, while, as soon as. Let's take the example and I will make it clear for you. When you come to Mumbai, pay us a visit. Take that particular example. In this particular example, there is a word called when. So when is a time clause introduced by conjunctions of time. So when is a conjunction of time? So we are supposed to use the simple present tense. Take the second example. I will not go out until it stops raining. In that particular second example, we have the word called until, which is a conjunction of time. So we are using the simple present tense. These two examples contain the time clauses such as when and until. The first example, when you come to Mumbai. Second example, I will not go out until it stops raining. So here the two examples, we have got the conjunctions of time. So we are to use the symbol present tense. What's the next usage of symbol present tense? We use it in conditional uses. What does it mean? I have given two examples here. If it rains, we will not come. What is the condition given there? If it rains, if that is a condition, we will not come. So to introduce conditional uses, to introduce the conditional clauses, we are using the simple present. Take the next example, if you heat water to 100 degrees, it boils. What is the condition here? The condition is that you have to heat water to 100 degrees. So if there is a conditional use, what happens is that we have to use the simple present tense. These two examples are conditional sentences because we have used the word if it rains, if you heat water to 100 degrees. In these two examples, we are using the simple present tense. So these are the different usages of simple present tense. I hope you have understood, and you can go through the notes once again so that it will be easy for you to understand. Now let's move on to the next, that is present continuous tense. When and where to use the present continuous tense? Take the first usage of present continuous tense, that is to denote something happening at the time of speaking, which means the action will be happening at the time of speaking. Let's go through the examples. He is sleeping now. Please call back as we are having dinner now. These two examples indicate that the actions are happening at the time of speaking. The first example, the action is sleeping, that is happening at the time of speaking. The second example, having dinner, is something that is happening at the time of speaking. So we have to use the present continuous tense. I hope it is clear for you. To denote something happening at the time of speaking, the first example, it is sleeping. The second example, having dinner. The second usage of present continuous tense is that to emphasize the present moment. Emphasize means to give importance to the present moment. Let's take the example. I am working as a teacher. What is to be emphasized in that particular sentence? It is working as a teacher has to be emphasized. Which means that is a present moment. I am working as a teacher. This example indicates the action that is taking place at the present moment. Working as a teacher is a present moment that is emphasized by the present continuous tense. So to emphasize or to give importance to the present moment, we use the present continuous tense. Let's move on to the next usage, that is to denote temporary actions even if the action is not happening at the moment. So these are temporary actions that are not happening at the moment of speaking. Let's go through the examples. I am reading a really great book. She is staying with her friend for a week. In these two examples, there are two actions. The first action is reading, second action staying. These two actions do not happen at the moment and they denote temporary actions. I am reading a really great book. It is not a permanent action. It is only a temporary action and that particular action does not happen at the moment. Second example, staying with her friend is not a permanent action. It is a temporary action which is not happening at the moment. So we use the present continuous tense to denote temporary actions even if the action is not happening at the moment. Let's move on to the next one. That is to indicate planned future actions. What does it mean? Let's go through the example. He is going to Paris next week. This sentence indicates a planned future action, which means an action that is going to happen in the future. And the future action in this particular sentence is going to Paris. So we are using the present continuous tense to indicate or to show planned future actions. Let's move on to the next usage, that is to indicate progressive change. Progressive change means gradual advancing. Gradual advancing means a slow improvement. Let's go through the examples. The situation is changing. Second example, world energy demand is increasing. Let's see what does it mean. These two sentences indicate a progressive change. Progressive change, I have already told you, it means a gradual advancing with the words changing and increasing. Okay, the first example, the situation is changing, which means the situation is gradually advancing. Second example, world energy demand is increasing. These two words, changing and increasing, indicate progressive change. So we use the present continuous tense. The next use of the present continuous tense is that it is used to denote frequent actions with adverbs of frequency. Words like always and forever are used. Let us understand it with the help of examples. She is always talking to him on the phone. Second example, you are always looking for faults. Let's see what does it mean. In these two examples, talking and looking indicate frequent actions implied by the word always. She is always talking, you are always looking. These are the two frequent actions indicated by the adverb of frequency, that is always. So we are using the present continuous tense. Let's take the next usage of present continuous tense. What is the next usage? We are using the present continuous tense in habitual actions which are new or temporary. Let's take these two examples. He is seeing a lot of Hindi films these days. What is habitual action in a particular sentence? That is seeing a lot of Hindi movies. These actions can be either new or temporary. The first example, seeing a lot of Hindi films these days, can be a new action or a temporary action. Second example, he's playing golf these days, which means the habitual action is playing golf, which can be a new, either a new or a temporary action. So we are using the present continuous tense. I hope you are clear or you have understood the usages of simple present and present continuous tense. I will be sending the PDF notes of these simple present and present continuous tense. Please go through it clearly and please understand it very, very clearly. I hope you are able to understand, you are able to comprehend what is taught by me. So thank you.